In this web page, we're using CSS to style our H2s and paragraphs so that all of the H2s are green and all of the paragraphs are purple. But what if we wanted to select just the first H2 or style just the second paragraph? We'd need to come up with a way to tell the browser exactly which of the elements we're selecting so that it didn't apply the styles to all of them like it is now. One way to do that is to select by ID. We can give a tag in our page a unique ID, and then we can tell CSS, listen here, I only want to apply these styles to the element with this ID, not to any of the other elements. To do that, the first step is actually modifying the HTML to add ID attributes to the tags we want to specifically select. Let's start with the second paragraph here. To add an ID attribute, we put our cursor in the start P tag, right after the P, then add a space, and then type ID equals quotes. Now we need to fill in this ID attribute with a value. What ID should I give it? Well, it should be descriptive and unique. Nothing else on this page should ever have the same ID. Well, since this is a song about rabbits, I'll call it rabbits-song. We can't have spaces in IDs, so if they have multiple words like this one, it should always use hyphens or underscores. I really like hyphens myself. Now we have a way of identifying this paragraph uniquely, so we can add a CSS rule targeting it. Let's go back up to our style tag for the second step. We'll add a new line after the last rule there. And now remember, the first part of CSS rule is the selector, the part that tells the browser what to select. In our previous rules here, we use selectors like H2 and P to select all of the H2 and P's on the page. Now, to make a selector that only selects elements with a particular ID, we must start the selector with a hash sign. That tells the browser that whatever is coming next is an ID. Now we write our ID, rabbits-song. The rest of the rule is the same as before. We open and close our curly braces, we add a property like background color, and ta-da! It worked! Only the song paragraph has the yellow background color, and the first paragraph stayed the same. Let's do this again for selecting this first H2. Can you remember the first step? That's right, we need to actually modify this HTML to add the ID attribute. So we stick our cursor in the start tag, add a space, type ID equals, and then type a very unique and descriptive ID. So rabbits-info-heading. Okay, the second step, back up in our style tag. We add a new line, write the hash sign, then our ID, rabbits-info-heading, and then put our properties inside curly braces. So background color purple. Uh-oh, okay, it didn't work. Do you see what went wrong? Did I spell it the same way? Rabbits-info-heading. So they look pretty much the same. Now I could compare them letter by letter to figure out what's wrong, but what I like to do is just go down and select the ID in the HTML and copy it and then paste it in here to make sure it's exactly the same. And it worked. My H2 has a background. Now, did you notice what changed? Maybe you did. It was the H here. The H used to be a capital H, which the browser does not consider the same. It has to be that lower H to match the HTML. That's because IDs are case sensitive, so you have to both spell them and case them the same way everywhere. I find it's best to just always use lowercase for every letter in my IDs, so I don't have to think about what casing I used when. Okay, now let me leave you with one last warning. IDs must be unique. If you have two tags on your page with the same exact ID, the browser might style both of them, but it also might style only one of them, and you don't want to leave that up to chance. Nice, unique, descriptive IDs.